Hey, thanks for coming back. We're following God's instructions. We're on step five, so. Number five says, prepare the largest faith seed you have ever sown. Write a check and in memo area print, divine inheritance. Okay, I opened up a bank account. It's check 100. This is the second one that I sent. I sold my car for $100, and you know, we have to leave here by New Year's, and we have no place to go. And I went into the store the other day, and there was a gentleman there, and his truck was squeaking when he pulled in. And I said, yeah, I used to have a truck that did the same thing. I said, if you get under there and lube a certain area, the squeaking will go down. And he said, it's not worth putting money into it. He said, I'm going to get rid of it at the first of the year. So I asked him how much he was going to sell it for. I don't know why I asked. And so I don't have the money to buy it. And he said he was going to just take it down to the scrapyard. And I don't know how much they give you down there, a couple $100. And he said, well, there's something wrong with the transmission. You know, I don't think you want it, you know. And I told him it would be like getting a Maserati because, I mean, that's God that just blessed us with a car. He said we could just have it after the first of the year. So, I mean, God, you know, you have to pay attention. We have to pay attention because blessings will come at us and we don't recognize and thank God for the work that he's doing, because that truly is a blessing from God, who just says, here, you can have the thing. I mean, it's just a blessing. And I thank God for that. So watch for your miracles, because they do happen. So I sold my car for $100, and 2 days later a man gives me a truck. It's an SUV. I mean, unbelievable. So $100, and I'm gonna make the check out. It says put in divine inheritance. Sure, I spell it right. Okay. So I did that and put $100. You know, the devil was telling me, spend it on the kids for Christmas, spend it on the kids for Christmas. And I didn't. And, you know, when I was younger, I seen the pastor and his wife, they had matching BMWs. And I said, look at this. I don't feel like I need to sow my seed, because they're just going to spend it and pay their car note or do something, you know, with it, you know, buy themselves a new dress or something. And as I got older, I realized, you know, it doesn't matter if your pastor or preacher has good intentions, as long as you are giving with good intentions and with faith, it doesn't matter if they go get a hooker, if the pastor goes and gets a hooker, God is going to bless you. And that's just the devil trying to keep you from sowing your seed. And it's just so important. It just shows how much you believe in God, and it's 100%. Yeah, 100%. Okay, we'll finish that up after. Okay. With God, everything is possible. I do believe. I just wanted to say that again. Can't say that enough. Prepare the largest faith seed that you have ever sown. Write the check in the memo area, printed, divine inheritance. Of course, I didn't print it. I have to tear that up. See, so never do anything right. Okay, number six. Look at the Jordan River miracle map and circle as many of the six miracles in red that you or your loved one needs. So then we're going to go over here, and here's the Jordan River map. Miracle money, healing, restoration, prosperity, miracles, and anointing. I was just looking at this, oh my gosh. Sorry about that, my feet were dirty. The devil said, wash it off, clean them. Okay. So, we need all the blessings that we can get. Miracle money, healing. We all need healing after the fire that occurred. My oldest daughter is going through post-traumatic stress syndrome as well as myself, and I know it affects my younger daughter as well, Courtney. Brandy's very sentimental, like, she's so sentimental. And so we just ask that the Lord mends their hearts and give them hope again. Without hope and faith, you're bankrupt. So we're going to circle miracle money, healing, healing is directed of Elijah and Naaman, dips in the Jordan 7 times and is completely healed of leprosy. So we need healing, asking for healing of the world too. I haven't been able to go to the doctor in quite some time. So, I was actually turned away because they wouldn't sign a release form. They refused service. And that's when I was having trouble breathing before the, before I drank the miracle spring water. I went in there and, you know, I was like, yeah, sign this if you want patient assistance. They said it's voluntarily. I was asking about patient assistance because I don't want to leave unpaid bills. I mean, even if I can send them $5 a month, I just don't want it going on, you know, my credit. And so anyway, restoration as direction of Elijah, the axe head was lost by one of the children of the prophets, floats up to the surface and is retrieved by the Jordan River. Restoration, yeah, that's what I was talking about. Restore us back, my children back, you know. It's